What's up, Kings and Queens? It's your girl QTP, and welcome back to the Queen Palace. May the 14th, I went out to enjoy dinner with someone. I arrived there at 7:40. My dinner reservation was at 8. Around 7:40, I came into the lot, preferred parking. I got out my car. I went to the kiosk. I read the directions, put my card in. Put the slot number in which my car was parked in. It said, thanks for your payment and let me know when my ticket will expire, which was Sunday, the next day at like around 5:20 or 5:30. Because I remember thinking about like, wow, that's a lot of time. I went inside the restaurant, had a great time. And when we left, I'm walking to my car. I'm clicking my button, my keys to, you know, hear my car beep back to me. And I don't hear anything. Looking crazy. And I realized, like, no, I parked right in front of the kiosk. And I was right in front of the kiosk standing looking stupid. I'm thinking, well, dang, did someone steal my car? Maybe it's been towed, but really I didn't believe my car was towed because I paid. There was no reason for my car to be towed, so I was thinking someone got me in these 704 streets. I called the towing company, which was on the pole, and they verified that we have your car. And I'm like, well, why? And they said, with the preferred parking system, there's no record of you paying. And I'm like, well, no, I paid. It told me on the kiosk, it said, thanks for your payment. It let me know when it will expire. I pay. I got a receipt. Unfortunately, the receipt was like pretty much blank. But it did say preferred parking on it. But it was posted or pending on my bank account. That means I swiped my card. It was pending for like 4 days. And then it just dropped. I was able to get my car out. It was $396.55. $400. A lot of money. Preferred Parking denied my request for a refund. And they basically said, you know, there were signs posted around the lot. And, you know, if you didn't pay, because in our system, it's saying that you didn't pay. It is what it is. I think they're trained to just deny all appeals. I was sad. I wanted to cry. Because it's like, at first, I was calm and cool because I knew it was going to work out because I pay, like, I swipe my card. It's pending on my bank statement. But then I was worried, like, what if they have some weird stuff going on, drop the payment, so it appears as though I never paid for parking. Because a lot of folks who was also having their cars towed actually was in the restaurant with us. But I guess no one else spoke up but me. Anyway, I began to feel like my voice wasn't being heard. Like I was violated. To have someone pick up my car and just take it away with ease. You have stolen my car. Then you charge me $400. Now I would see if I came in there under the intent to get by, not pay, then yeah, I should take that L. Like that's a natural consequence of me being deceitful. That wasn't the case, you know. So now, like, I felt like I can't do nothing to defend myself. So I contacted the attorney general. They advised me to file a complaint. Cool. I also contacted the local news, and Mr. Nate was able to respond to me. And he met with me for an interview to explain what happened. After that, he said, well, you know what? I'm going to first do an investigation.